Omyoji. Oh, Shinpachi. Okay, episode 196. And we've been introduced into a whole different kind of world of in Gintama with the Omyoji, with the Shikigami. Head of the Ketsuno clan. Ooh. Not losing to the wind. That's a weird way of describing it. Oh, so I'm right that they're part of the. I guess they somewhat hinted that before. I think they've. I just missed it from the last episode. So they've been part of the Amanto War as well, I'm assuming. Ooh. Wonder what they think about with the Amanto. If they're serving under the Bakufu. This is quite another unexpected turn to this situation. So it's not them causing Ketsuno Anna's demise. So maybe it's another clan. And this is reminded me of something like with Kyubey's situation where the clan is so devoted to her. Oh yeah. So they're not really capable of controlling the weather. Ooh, what's that? Another clan. And here I thought this is going to be a serious arc. The Sherina clan. Oh, maybe this is the clan of the other girl. What was her name? The one who replaced Ketsuno Anna. Forgot her name. Oh. Who is this person? Oh. Oh, they're going back. They're going back to that. They're making sure that they're connecting the dots of what she was before. That's why she came back. But never thought that there's a deeper meaning to what happened to her going back. I don't know what to expect. I guess I'll just be prepared for anything. Oh, that's a Naruto thing. That's a ninjutsu. What a trivial thing to do for revenge. I think they're still again. Sister lover. I wonder, I guess it's just they need to defeat the other clan. Yeah, who would have thought? She's loyal to Ketsuno Anna. Yeah. Which is different to what she somewhat introduced herself as. I guess because Ketsuno Anna is really powerful. What are they doing there? He had to sacrifice his sister. Yeah. I guess he's doing it for a greater cause, but still, it was really conflicting. Because either that or it's peace, but I guess it didn't really matter. So that's why he's somewhat regretting doing that. Because it never really brought peace between the two clans. It's going to be a duel between two. Yep. Shigigai tag team. But I guess Gin could participate because he has a Shikigami with Gedomaru. He really setting him up to be his brother-in-law. Sister Princess. Not bro. But who's going? I guess that the third one might be someone just from the clan. I guess it's her own way of but I never expected Kitsuno Ana to be that kind of person because if I remember when she was introduced it's more like she's like a TV personality that's just I guess doing it for the fame but I guess this gives her a lot more character development. Ooh. Why? Bob cut. Yeah, that's not stopping in. Oh, he's oh, the inspiration that oh. Ooh, I wonder who's stronger. Yeah, I think that. Oh, I thought that she would test Gintoki's strength, but I guess she's just testing Gintoki's resolve. Oh. Shinpachi is going to be the. Or maybe she could use Sadaharu. Oh, what if Sadaharu is a Shikigami? Because I don't think they've really confirmed what Sadaharu was. And we've seen Sadaharu turn into a monster. Thank you. But I hope we get to see more of Senmi, because they introduced him as to be the most powerful Omyoji. Oh, Shinpachi! I think it should be the other way around if they're going to and that road. Shinpachi will die. I think it should be the other around. I suspected that maybe she's going. I guess they don't have that much time. I think it would be a lot more suitable, or a lot more common sense to have at least Sadaharu, because Sadaharu is, I think, if we go back, I think maybe those girls back then that was trying to restrain, I guess, raise Sadaharu was also maybe some kind of sorcerer. So I thought that they were going to involve that in this, to connect that in this episode. But yeah, Shinpachi is going to be the Shikigami. And he even has the costume for it. But man, I think Kagura is way stronger than Shinpachi, so at least. But I guess knowing Kagura, she doesn't want to be troubled and to be involved that much. So I feel bad for Shinpachi. Hopefully she won't get to be someone, but it's a tag team, so he has to fight. I guess they're only up against one opponent, but yeah, I guess he's really powerful. But another thing is that I hope that Senmei will also show some bit of his powers, because we've only seen him use his powers with the, I guess, defend the attack from the other Omyoji, and also with the guys to summoning the food. But we've never really seen anything that promising from him so far. But they've introduced him as the most powerful Omyoji of the clan. So hopefully he'd also be able to step up and also with regards to Gintoki and Gedomaru, so which is really cool that they've delved into that with regards to her character even more, and also with Ketsuno Anna. So what my impression of her from the beginning was, yes, she's just this ordinary television personality, or just a weathercast forecaster, and we've never really expected much from her, rather than just being always the reporter on the scenes, something like that, as I guess a filler character, a side character, and we've never really had that much development from her, and except that Gin really looks up to her. So yeah, it's another cool thing is that Gintama has, I guess they're looking for another person to explore a bit more, and they've never done that with Ketsuno Anna. So, but the thing is, it's it's a whole different realm when they they introduce Ketsuno Anna to the story even more, and they introduce this whole different aspect of the Omyoji. Omyoji with the sorcerers, with the Shikigami. But it's a really cool addition to the Gintama world, and hopefully they continue to connect it with the Gintama. So maybe because of Gintoki's contract or something like that with Gedomaru. So maybe hopefully we get to see also Gedomaru be involved in fights in helping Gintoki. But I guess but at the same time, I'm somewhat feeling that this is just a whole its own story, its own arc, and it's just going to be something like a secret society of sorcerers that is trying to control the weather, something like that, and they wouldn't be that much involved with regards to the I guess the political affairs with regards to the other events of with Edo. So yeah, but yeah, things are, and also with regards to the introduction of the Doman, forgot his name already. Is it Doman? Yeah, I think it's Doman. Yeah, maybe I think it's really be it's just going to be a one it's just this whole different world of Society of Omyoji, and especially after seeing that battle between the two clans, and but yeah, they did show that how much they appreciate Ketsuno Anna. And with regards to this other clan that I guess just hates the other clan as much. So yeah, what else? So yeah, and also with regards to the contest of tag team, we also learned that Doman's main motivation is just to get revenge to their the Ketsuno clan. So because maybe because the Ketsuno clan is the most is the more recognizable, the most considered as an official Omyoji of the Bakufu of the Shogun. So because I don't think they've, maybe you just missed it, but if you do know, please let me know in the comments the reason why the other clan hates Ketsuno clan. Because it seems like it's just a feud that has been going on for a long time. But yeah, I think eventually they'd be able to defeat the Doman. But I think they would really have to work hard to it. And it seems like, because if Senmei is really powerful and this guy is, they're showing that he's a lot more powerful than Senmei. So they would definitely have a hard time winning against them unless they found some kind of maybe weakness, or maybe he has some kind of limitations. Because Gedomaru said that maybe it seems like the mark on Doman's face is somewhat a sign that he is dealing with forbidden arts, and usually whenever they deal with forbidden or forbidden jutsu, things like that, there's always some kind of a limitation or a catch with regards to that. So yeah, but this whole different society, this whole different mechanics of power that has been introduced to the Gintama, I'm still not sure whether it's going to be part of the canon of the whole Gintama series, but I feel like it's possible, because maybe it's the other side of some kind of sci-fi, but I guess it's a mixture of the sci-fi with the Gintama and with the maybe because they said that they've been serving also the Shogun, the Bakufu for a long time, so definitely they have been involved with the Amanto War. So but yeah, so those are my thoughts in this episode. If you would like to share yours, just let me know in the comments down below, and if you think I've missed some details or maybe some things that I've said is wrong with regards to what has happened so far, please do let me know, and I would really appreciate that, so at least I would be able to have a better understanding of this story, of this arc, and if you did enjoy watching my reaction to this episode, please like this video and subscribe if this is your first time here, so you'll be updated whenever I upload my reaction videos. And if you want to watch my reaction to the next episode, it's also now available on my Patreon. Just go to the link in the description down below, and there you will have an early access, and it will support this channel and help me create more reaction videos like this in the future. So thank you again for watching. See you in my next video. Hope you had a great day. Goodbye.